It's AumSum time!
Why is Pluto not a planet anymore? Because I'm not silly anymore. Yeah, yeah. Now listen. Pluto was discovered by Clyde Tombaugh in 1930. It is not considered a planet anymore because in 2006, astronomers of IAU gave a new definition to the word planet. According to the new definition, a planet is a celestial body, which is in orbit around the sun, is spherical in shape, and it has cleared the neighborhood around its orbit. What does this mean? It basically means that using its gravity, a planet should have removed asteroids and dwarf planets out of its path, thus cleared its neighborhood. Now, Pluto is in orbit around the sun and is spherical in shape. But since Pluto's neighborhood has many other objects and it has not cleared its neighborhood, it is not called a planet anymore. Why do dead whales explode?
Because there are thousands of firecrackers in their bodies.
Ugh, stop bluffing. When a dead whale accidentally gets washed up on a beach, it begins to decompose as it is not eaten up by sharks or other fishes. During decomposition, various gases like methane and carbon dioxide are produced within its body. But since there is a thick layer of blubber under the skin of whales, the gases cannot escape out. Thus, they begin to build up inside the whale's body, causing it to bloat. Now, such gases are also produced in other animals after their death. But since the body of a whale is large, it produces more gases, thus increasing the pressure in its body. Eventually, due to the increased pressure, the accumulated gases, tissues, flesh, etc., forcefully come out through weak spots, thus creating an explosion. Hence, it is always advised to not stand or sit on a dead whale because it might lead to increased pressure at weak spots, thus causing an explosion. What causes tides? Tides are the periodic rise and fall of sea level at a particular place. When the sea level rises to its greatest height, it is known as a high tide, and when the sea level drops to its lowest height, it is known as a low tide. Tides are primarily caused due to the gravitational force of the moon.
But how?
Part of the Earth facing the moon experiences a stronger gravitational pull towards the moon as compared to the Earth's center. So, the part facing the moon is pulled away from the center, creating a bulge and thus increasing the sea level and causing a high tide. Now, the Earth's center experiences a stronger gravitational force towards the moon than the part facing away from the moon. Hence, this part is pulled away from the center, resulting in high tide on the opposite side as well. In addition to this, the places in between the two high tides, where the sea level drops, experience low tides.
Why do snakes shed their skin?
Wait, I'll explain. When a snake grows, its outer skin layer called epidermis does not grow or get bigger with it. Hence, the snake sheds its epidermis periodically to allow further growth of its body. In addition to this, shedding also helps remove parasites present on the epidermis.
So does the snake buy a new skin?
No. First, listen. Before shedding, the snake grows a new epidermis beneath the old one and secretes a fluid between the old and new epidermis. This fluid helps separate the old epidermis from the new one. Once this is done, the process of shedding begins. To remove the old epidermis, the snake rubs its head against any hard surface, creating a tear either near mouth or near nose area. Then, it drags and wriggles its body against any hard surface and slowly slithers out of the old epidermis.